So here I am with Bob Steinfeld, an employee of Apple.
Correct.
For how many years? 20 years or so?
26 years.
And not only is he an engineer for Apple, he has a metal shop where he can teach you how to make just about anything out of metal. Tell me about it, Bob.
Right. So we have milling machines, lathes, welding equipment. We can do TIG, MIG, arc welding, oxyacetylene welding. I have a number of people that come and use the shop on a regular basis. One guy who makes knives for a hobby. I got another guy that likes to make tools for a hobby.
So if I'm a tinkerer that just wants to make something for my own hobby, or I'm an inventor that wants to create a prototype, you could help me with that?
So I can help you with that. One of the things I've done in the past, I taught metalworking and welding at night school for 20 years. And so I have a lot of experience teaching people, and I really enjoy doing that part of the work.
And you've also played a hand for a couple of decades now, maybe two or three decades, in building electric cars. Tell me about what's behind me here.
Yeah, so what's behind you here is my fifth electric car. I built the first car in 1973 based on an NSU chassis, which was a very lightweight German car. And then I built a couple of those, and then I built a Volkswagen Baja Bug. And I built a tube frame chassis, and then I built this car right here.
So I tell you, when I was a kid, I would have loved to have had a dune buggy. But now that I'm 50 and we're living in a planet that's running out of fuel, I'd love to have an electric dune buggy. And you've got one here that's just absolutely remarkable. Tell me about it.
So this is a great electric dune buggy. It has 12 batteries. It's running on 96 volts. And I'm using 8-volt batteries. You want to try and boost the voltage up as high as possible to reduce the resistance losses in the cable due to high current. And if we look on the back here, we can see the motor and the batteries along the side. And it's very fun to drive. All the battery weight is below the axle level. It corners like a go-kart.
So how far would I be able to go on a charge?
About 20 to 30 miles.
That's a lot of fun.
It's a lot of fun. Now, electric cars are a little bit different. The terrain depends a lot on how far you can go.
So try to go downhill as much as you can to get a little better distance.
It's great to go downhill.
But you got to go uphill sometimes.
You got to go uphill sometimes. I happen to live on top of a hill, which is the worst place to live with an electric car, because at the end of the day, I have to climb the hill.
There you go. Well, Bob, fascinating story. We're going to come over to your studio to do a follow-up and see the internal workings of what you've built here.
Okay. Very nice to talk to you.
Thank you. I'm just kidding.